Welcome to our guide on perfecting your Linux virtualization experience with VirtualBox. Whether you're a Linux veteran or a newbie in the virtualization world, we've got you covered. In this video, we'll walk you through 10 critical VirtualBox settings that will boost the stability, performance, and convenience of your virtual Linux setups. So, let's dive right in. Selecting the right Linux version. Our journey begins with the critical decision of choosing the right Linux distribution. While there's a wide array to choose from, I highly recommend starting with Ubuntu, especially if you're new to Linux. Ubuntu is renowned for its user-friendliness, extensive community support, and well-documented resources. Familiarity with your chosen distribution can significantly streamline your VirtualBox experience. Allocating adequate RAM. Now, let's talk about RAM allocation. When creating a new virtual machine, it's crucial to allocate the right amount of RAM. The memory size should align with the system requirements of the Linux distribution you plan to install. For instance, Ubuntu recommends a minimum of 4 GB. I've learned the hard way that insufficient memory can lead to severe lag, while overallocation can slow down your host machine. It's all about finding that sweet spot. Setting up the virtual hard disk. Choosing the right virtual hard disk configuration is another pivotal choice. In my experience, I've found VDI, VirtualBox Disk Image, to be the most reliable format. But the decisions don't stop there. You must also decide between dynamically allocated and fixed-size disks. Dynamically allocated disks consume space on your physical hard drive as they fill up, while fixed-size disks immediately allocate the space you define. I lean towards fixed-size disks for better performance. Enabling the bidirectional clipboard. The bidirectional clipboard is a feature that can make your life much easier. It allows you to seamlessly copy and paste between your host machine and the virtual machine. Surprisingly, this feature is disabled by default. To enable it, head over to Settings, General, Advanced, Shared Clipboard, and select Bidirectional. Along with the clipboard, enabling drag and drop to bidirectional can also streamline your workflow. I can't emphasize enough how many times this setting has saved me valuable time and effort. Installing guest editions. First, start by updating your Ubuntu guest operating system software packages using following command, sudo apt update. Sudo apt upgrade. Once upgrade completes, reboot your Ubuntu guest operating system to effect the recent upgrades. Install required packages as follows. You can initiate the installation process by clicking Devices in the Virtual Machine Windows menu bar and selecting Insert Guest Edition CD Image. If you're using Ubuntu, you'll notice a disk icon appear in the dock. Click it to view the contents of the inserted image. Right-click the otorrent.sh script and select Run as a Program from the context menu. Enter your administrator password to continue. Once done, the terminal will display the progress of the installation. It enhances your virtual machine's functionality by offering better mouse pointer integration, improved video support, seamless window integration, and shared folders. Adjusting display settings. Customizing display settings to your preference is essential. In the virtual machine settings, you can fine-tune video memory and enable 3D acceleration under the display section. However, I've noticed that some Linux distributions may not play well with 3D acceleration, leading to screen flickering issues. If you encounter such problems, consider disabling it. Allocating CPU cores. By default, VirtualBox allocates only one CPU core to your virtual machine. You can adjust this setting in System, Processor tab within the virtual machine settings. If your host system boasts a multi-core processor, you have the opportunity to enhance your virtual machine's performance by allocating more cores. Remember to always leave at least one core for your host system to operate smoothly. Enabling VTX AMD-V. Now, let's delve into the hardware virtualization technologies known as VTX, Intel Virtualization Technology, and AMD-V, AMD Virtualization. These technologies can significantly boost your virtualization performance by allowing VirtualBox to execute code directly on the physical CPU, with minimal intervention from the host OS. If these options are grayed out in VirtualBox, you might need to enable virtualization in your computer's BIOS settings. Consult your motherboard or system documentation for guidance. Setting network mode. VirtualBox offers several network modes, including NAT, bridged, internal, and host-only. The default NAT mode is sufficient for regular internet use within the virtual machine. However, if you want your virtual machine to function as a fully integrated machine within your network, bridged mode is your go-to option. While NAT mode is suitable for most use cases, the choice of the right network mode heavily depends on your specific requirements. Be sure to research each mode's features to make an informed decision. Taking snapshots. Finally, let's talk about snapshots, a feature that can be a real lifesaver. Snapshots enable you to save a specific state of your virtual machine, which you can revert to whenever needed. This is incredibly useful when experimenting or trying out new configurations. Trust me, it saved my skin more times than I care to admit. Make it a habit to take snapshots regularly, especially before making significant changes to your virtual machine. Additionally, keep an eye on your snapshot library to remove old, unnecessary snapshots and save disk space. In conclusion, my journey with Linux on VirtualBox has been filled with learning opportunities, occasional frustrations, and a deep sense of satisfaction. With these 10 settings, I hope you'll have a smoother ride, avoiding the bumps I encountered. If you found this video informative and valuable, don't forget to hit the like button, share it with others, and subscribe to our channel for more in-depth tech tutorials. Thank you for watching, and happy virtualizing with Linux. Until next time, keep experimenting and keep learning.